Hi and welcome to Vynix Studio. If you have been following along, we are trying to make an endless runner game and we have already set up the player movement and the camera follow visual script. In this tutorial, we'll try to respawn the ground endlessly so that the player has a feel that they are running on an endless ground.
Welcome to Vynix Studio. Let's start making games.
So what we'll be doing is we'll be taking this plane and we'll try to respawn the plane in front of the player so that as soon as the player moves to a particular distance, there'll be a new plane in front. It will go on till the end, till the player loses the game, so it will be basically endless. Now, instantiating and destroying will lead to a lot of garbage value, so we'll not be instantiating and destroying. We'll have two instances of the plane, and we'll try to move them in front of each other as the player moves forward. So let's duplicate this plane. So we have plane 1. We'll move it to the back of our original plane. So if we move it here, so you can see that it's 100 units apart. So I'll set it to minus 100. So now I have two grounds, plane and plane 1. So as soon as my player comes to the center of plane, I'll move this plane 1 to the front of the player. And as soon as the player goes to that plane, I'll move the other plane in front of the player. So I'll keep on doing this. So that way it will give you an endless feel, and all that you need is two game objects. So you can replace this with any environment game object that you have. So I'm doing it with a regular Unity plane. Now to write the script for that, let's select the plane and click on add component and search for script machine, select script machine, and we'll create a new graph. Let's call this graph as endless spawn. Okay, so before we edit the graph, we need the player variable. So let's go ahead and create a player variable, a public player. And it will be of type game object. So let's drag a capsule and put it here. So let's click on edit graph here. We are going to get the Z distance of the player and we are going to take the Z distance of our plane. And if the difference is greater than 100, then we are going to add 200. That is the actual distance of two planes because we have to get in front of the other plane. So we are going to add 200 to the Z position of the plane. So we'll do everything in the update. So we don't require the start. So inside the update, first thing that we are going to get is the player position. So let's go to object, let's drag the player here. So get variable, and then we need to get the position. Get position transform, yeah. Then we need to get the Z position of this, so get Z, okay. And then we also need to get the position of the plane, so it will be get position. So since we are connecting this visual graph to our plane, we don't need to specify the object. It will be this. And then we need to get Z. Okay. So we have the player position and we'll subtract that from the plane's position. So all we need is a subtract node. Okay. So player minus plane. And then we're going to have a greater than node. Okay. So in B, we'll type in 100. So we'll connect this. So next, we'll add an if node. And in the if node, we'll just take the value of the greater than block. Then we'll create a vector 3. So let's search vector 3. And let's say create vector 3 of x, y, and z. Okay. So we'll create the vector 3 and we'll set that to the set position. Since we're already getting the position of the plane here, we'll just do get y. And we'll also do get x. Okay. So let's put it somewhere here so that it's easier to understand. Okay, so let's connect x and let's connect Y. And in case of Z, we need to take this and we need to use an add. So let's create another graph variable. So let's go out and let's create a variable called distance. So this will be the distance to which you have to move the plane. So let's click on the plus sign and the value will be a float. And now it is 200. Okay, now let's go back to our graph. Inside the object, we should have the distance variable. Okay, so we'll connect that to B. And we are adding the Z to B. And if it is true, we'll set that to Z and it will be set to the position. If it is false, we don't have to do anything. The plane will remain wherever it is. So let's just close the graph. Now, before we start the game, we also need to set the same graph to plane 1. So let's again search for script machine. And for the graph, we'll just select endless spawn. And we also need to set these variables. So we'll just go to the plane and we'll click on copy component. And then we'll go to plane 1 and we'll say paste component. And then we'll remove this component. Okay, so now we have the variables. So let's just move it up. Okay, now let's play the game. So we'll come to the scene view to have a better view. So you can see that the player is moving. The camera is actually following the player. And as soon as the player reaches half of the distance of the ground, the plane on the back should come to the front. Okay, it doesn't come to the front, it goes somewhere else. Okay, we forgot to do one thing. We forgot to actually set the value here. Okay. So let's just make sure it is changed in both the graph. Yeah, it is there. So let's go back and test it out. So the player is moving. And as soon as the player reaches half the distance, the plane on the back should come to the front. Yes, it does. So we'll wait for the player to move even further. Okay, so basically this will keep on happening. So the player will never run out of ground. So we'll just do a quick recap. We are getting the player position, we are getting the ground position, and we are taking the Z value of both and subtracting them to find out if the value is greater than 100. And if the distance between the player and the ground is greater than 100, we are adding an offset value, which in my case is 200. It might differ depending on the length of your environment. So it should be basically 2 times the length of your environment. So in my case, the environment is 100 units. So the value here is 200. We're adding the plane Z position and 200 and setting it if the distance between the player and the ground is greater than 100. So now we have set up the player movement, we have set up the camera follow, and we have made an endless ground. So only thing that is remaining is the obstacles. So in the next video, we'll see how to spawn obstacles randomly and how to increase the speed of the game as the time progresses. Thank you and see you in the next tutorial.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.